October 26, 2021, a dawn ceremony on the Aotearoa foreshore. Bearers carry a symbolic carved Bible to mark the moment 200 years ago that the gospel arrived to these shores.
Right where I'm standing right now, where the passage is on my left, that is where the gospel first arrived, and it arrived to the beautiful island of Aitutaki. Aitutaki is the very first island to receive the Christianity in the whole of the Cook Island, and it was accepted by the chief, Tamato.
The celebration starts well before dawn, the island woken by the sound of beating drums. As the ata bearing the Bible is borne to Orongo Park, locals join Aronga Mana and other church and government dignitaries to unveil the bicentennial commemorative stone.
The people in Aitutaki have been looking forward for this special occasion, and today we are glad to say that not only Aitutaki had come together for this celebration, but all the Pa'enua, the different islands in the Cook Island, from the northern group right down to the southern group.
Christianity's played a huge part in the lives of the people here for two centuries, and in October 1821, it was the Reverend John Williams from the London Missionary Society who arrived at these shores. He was accompanied by two Tahitian converts, Papehia and Va'apata. Embraced by the High Chief Tamato Ariki, Williams left the two Tahitians to teach the gospel while he continued his journey. When he returned nearly 2 years later, the conversion to Christianity was almost complete.
The Ariki of the island accepted Christianity. If the Ariki did not accept it, we would not have Christianity or the gospel here in the Cook Islands.
200 years on, it's a much different Aitutaki, but a community nevertheless that's proud of its Christian heritage. And helping people here celebrate are Cook Islanders from neighbouring islands or Pa'enua.
It's very historical for us, and we're very honoured to come from Rarotonga. Although most of us are from Aitutaki as well, we're very happy to be here to witness these celebrations this year.
I guess one for the archives for me, but certainly to be back where I grew up as a young kid. I was banking on being part of this celebration for a while, and you know, a 200-year bicentennial celebration doesn't come too often.
Years of planning and fundraising's gone into this celebration, which is tinged with some sadness for locals. Border closures due to COVID meant many overseas Cook Islanders and fellow Christians could not attend. For some, though, it was a blessing in disguise.
We are all sad. We really feel sorry for them. We only hope they can make it here. But God's love.
I'm sure most of them crying, wishing they're here.
A lot of our families from Aotearoa and Australia can't be here with us. But thank goodness to modern technology, we're able to share images and audio with our family and friends right around the globe.
It turned out to be a blessing for us that the border wasn't open. Not in a, I don't want to say that in a negative way, but I don't think we would have coped if tourism was here. It's hard enough to cater for the people that came from within our country.
Aitutaki was the first to welcome the gospel to the Cook Islands. The missionaries would reach neighbouring islands, including Rarotonga, in 1823. Plans are already afoot to mark the event on those islands in 2 years. For many on Aitutaki, this event has helped reaffirm their Christian faith, but also that it can't be taken for granted.
What will happen in the next 100 years? Will there be another celebration like what we are having today? Will our relationship in Christianity be 100% in the future, or will it be a hardship for the people of Aitutaki and the Cook Islands?
Somewhere along the line, we're starting to let go of Christianity, let go of God, and we're seeing the things that people are facing. What we need now is to be on track with God, build that relationship with God, and be ready for God when His Son Jesus will come and take us back to heaven.